If you've never heard of Ravi Zacharias, I totally forgive you. He was an incredibly insignificant person. But if your husband suckers you into reading bullshit Christian books, you'll know the name. For decades, he was one of the leading authors in the world of Christian apologetics. He was like Hillary Morgan Fair with a more expensive vocabulary. And he was well known enough that when he died in May, top-ranking U.S. evangelical Mike Pence spoke at his funeral. And then about 6 minutes after he was interred, the sexual assault allegations started rolling in. See, in addition to his ministry, Zacharias owned a couple of health spas in Georgia. And according to multiple former employees, he had been, quote, sexually out of control with the female therapist over whom he had professional power, end quote. An investigative report in Christianity Today is a little more explicit. They had three women on record that say he, quote, touched them inappropriately, exposed himself, and masturbated during regular treatment, end quote. This went on for years. Now, to their credit, when these allegations surfaced, the ministry did hire a law firm to conduct an outside investigation and have been open about the findings so far. But how low is the fucking bar before that's even worth mentioning? They didn't lie to cover up the crimes of a dead man, and at this point, that's more than we can expect from a ministry. And the whole thing is yet another reminder that the louder a Christian proclaims their moral authority, the more immoral they turn out to have been the entire time. That kind of hypocrisy springboards me into our next story pretty nicely. And that's the most recent press release from Operation Rescue. Quick refresher, they're the Kansas anti-abortion group most directly associated with the 2009 assassination of Dr. George Tiller. After years of disseminating manufactured propaganda against him, he was eventually killed by an Operations Rescue supporter that had donated thousands of dollars to the group and got information about Dr. Tiller's whereabouts from their senior policy advisor. Now, you'd think that a group that inspired murder like that would have already reached peak hypocrisy when it came to calling themselves pro-life. But every year, the group gives out what they call the Malachi Award for service to the pro-life movement. Past recipients include Phil Klein, the former Kansas AG who harassed Planned Parenthood so relentlessly that he ended up losing his law license for it in 2013. Well, this year, they decided that the person that best exemplified the pro-life stance was none other than Donald fucking Trump, the man responsible for the most American deaths since the guy who invented gunpowder. That's right, Donald, it'll magically disappear. Old people should sacrifice themselves for the economy. What if we just inject bleach? Trump was the most pro-life person they could think of. It's funny. Originally, I thought about doing a misogyny year in review thing for this segment, but then I saw that story and I was like, how could any summary encapsulate 2020 better than a story about an anti-abortion group patting Donald Trump for, quote, building a culture of life, end quote. And on that note, I'll hand things back over to Noah, Heath, and Eli.